The 80s had some of the most interesting and questionable trends. Everything from music, fashion, hairstyles, they were all in your face.
Follow the yellow brick road.
Lace clothing was everywhere in the 1980s, mostly thanks to Madonna.
Desperately Seeking Susan has already made millions in the States, and it stars the hottest property on the music scene at the moment, Madonna. She's become the darling of the teeny boppers and inspired a generation to copy her distinctive style.
Her influence on stage and in her music videos, and because of her role in the 1985 movie Desperately Seeking Susan. Gloves and headbands to sheer tops and leggings. Anything could be and everything was made of lace in the 1980s. It screamed rebel, and so many teens of the era was ready to break free and stick it to the man. Madonna was a poster child for breaking the mold and influencing fashion to become a form of self-expression, especially to the gay community, of course. By the way, if you're wondering why I'm sitting outside, it's such a lovely day outside and I do all my videos on one day, so I decided to do the videos outside today for a change. New wave music evolved from punk in the late 1970s, being less antisocial and more radio and MTV friendly, hitting its high in 1983, and everybody wanted their share of the phenomenon. Singers like Kim Wilde, Kylie Minogue, and every other boy band from the 1980s decided to cash in on the newfound phenomenon that is new wave. The genre complemented the big hairstyles, outrageous outfits, and shoulder pads perfectly. The music resonated strongly with the listeners as it mirrored their own desires and longing better than other genres of music of the time.
I'll be back. I am your father.
1, 2, come for you.
Slasher movies were all the rage back in the 1980s. You couldn't go to a cinema without seeing a poster of Halloween, Friday the 13th, or some other random slasher movie that came out that year. After the groundbreaking cinema of the 1970s, the 80s were often seen as a bit of a disappointment, but the 80s brought us some of the best slasher movies of all time. Take, for example, Sleepaway Camp. Inspired by slasher movies like Friday the 13th, Sleepaway Camp boasts a dedicated cult following, with the film's twist ending being considered one of the most surprising in cinematic history. Would this movie have received the same favorable reviews if it was made and released today? Probably not. So it's a good thing that the movie was made and released back in the 1980s, when slashers were still new and fresh. Thank you for watching this video. If you enjoyed this video, please remember to click like and subscribe. That way you'll stay up to date as soon as I post a new video. I post new videos every Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. For a similar video to this one that I specifically picked out for you, click on this link or try the YouTube suggestion.